is it that surpluses equal yield? Isn't yield derived from resource inputs to the system? When trying to find the right balance and avoiding overabundance, we're primarily considering yield or resource consumption within a system. Well, ideally, your system produces resources and doesn't consume them. So we're looking at mostly living resources, and for that to happen, you have to be linked to photosynthesis. So everything, all living things, their source of energy comes from the sun. We're really solar collectors. Everything we've eaten has been a plant or a vegetable source of some sort, or an animal that has had a vegetable source, right? So it's fed on vegetation, or it's an animal that's had an animal that's had vegetation as its main food source. And all that vegetation has gained its energy through from solar capture through photosynthesis to solid material. So if we track our energy back, it all comes back to the sun. If we put together systems that are life-rich and diverse, they capture enormous amounts of energy from the sun, and that becomes a resource that supplies our system. So we reduce our inputs and extend our on-site created resource outputs, and therefore we've got a system that is truly sustainable. Now that's what we're working towards, reducing our inputs or eliminating our inputs. So, or if we have very small inputs that well and truly overcompensated by our outputs, which are the majority produced on site. And that's a matter of connectivity between the diversity of elements. So it's not just diversity, it's the interactivity of the diversity that we put together. And that's how nature works.